hovering high above Progressive Field and Cleveland for the 90th Major League Baseball All-Star Game. Welcome back to our set down the first baseline here at Progressive Field. That's right, the big hurt, the Hall of Famer Frank Thomas. A-Rod, Alex Rodriguez is here. I'm Kevin Burkhardt. We've gone to the bullpen. We've called in our guy, Ken Rosenthal. Ken, always a pleasure to see you, my man.
Thanks, Kevin.
So let's dive in and let's talk about the number one talked about name in this trade market. It's Madison Bumgarner, right? Everybody wants him, or at least a lot of teams do. What are you hearing? What are you feeling about Bumgarner, where he's going to be going?
Well, it's interesting. You talk to some of the teams, always at this time of year, you hear, well, he's not really all that good.
Yeah.
Not what he was in 10 and 12 and 14 in October. Well, no kidding. But he is a guy whose stuff has come back. And his velocity's up, strikeout rate's up, walk rate's good. The question has been the hard hit percentage. He's given up a lot of hard hit balls. In fact, the highest rate in the National League. And that is a fair concern. But a couple of starts ago, he made an adjustment. Started using both sides of the plate more. And it looks like he's coming around a little bit. Guys have to adjust now. The ball is alive. The offense is thriving everywhere. And pitchers do have to do some different things. He is Madison Bumgarner. He's a guy capable of special things. We know that. So what I reported today was that among the teams showing interest, this is not an exclusive list, but among the teams, the Brewers, the Braves, the Twins, and the Astros. Now, he has an 18 no-trade list. And we'll show you the list right here. It's not a list that is necessarily prohibitive, though. It's a list where he basically picked the teams he thought might want him. Just in case there's an agreement, he'll have some leverage. Smart man. Might want to get some more money out of this. So it says the headline there, that's a no for me. No, it's not. It's just a possibility of a no, and that could get him something in return. But I do expect he will be traded. I do expect that he will bring a return similar to what the Rangers got for Yu Darvish a couple of years ago. It's not going to be great. He's a potential free agent. 2 months, Madison Bumgarner, you're not getting the world for him. But, Alex, this is still a guy that a lot of teams are going to say, okay, he's someone we can trust in October.
Yeah, no question about it. And look, October is about peace of mind. And when you think about the Yankees championships, it has been David Wells, Andy Pettit, Ron Guidry. You need that left-hander. This guy's not only 30. KB, you brought up a great point in the green room. This guy has a lot at stake. He's only made $57 million in his entire career.
Only.
12 this year. Well, in comparison to others, Kenny.
Absolutely.
I mean, here's a guy who's looking at Chris Sale, and he says he can do that. But the bottom line is this guy has a lot at stake. Maybe New York is not long-term, but if you're the Yankees, you're 14th in the American League in starting pitching. That is a hole, and you got to fill it. And not with a three or four, but with a number one, and that's Madison Bumgarner.
And I feel the same way as you, A-Rod. This guy's been grossly underpaid for what he's done on the big stage for World Series championships. I love his list. There's no list because he deserves more money, and I think that's what's going to happen. Have you heard anything about that at all?
No, I don't know that he'll press Frank for an extension necessarily, but maybe he gets $1 million to approve the trade, something along those lines.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, the point is, though, he's never gotten the big kind of the sale, the Scherzer kind of, he's never gotten that despite all his postseason success, a 2-1-1 ERA in the postseason. So, you know, he's got to be feeling like it.
And keep in mind, Kevin, it's in his interest to be traded. Because if he gets traded in the middle of a season as a potential free agent, no qualifying offer, no draft pick compensation, he'll be an unrestricted free agent.
And Kenny, to your point, that ERA, all that stuff, you can go like this. It doesn't matter. You saw Cole Hamels go from Texas to the Cubs. There's an uptick. These guys understand October baseball. They're not going to be frightened. And now you, Mr. Big Hurt, you have some breaking news.
No breaking news at all. I was in Chicago yesterday for the Sox-Cubs, and Theo Epstein is not happy with his Cub team right now. Have you heard anything about maybe a trade to break up some of the monotony in that clubhouse?
Yes, and they certainly are looking to upgrade. And Frank, you're absolutely right. Theo Epstein and Jed Hoyer both have been public in the last week expressing their dissatisfaction with the team's performance. What is one way to shake it up? To bring in some new blood. Now, I know one guy they like. He's currently on the injured list. David Peralta from the Diamondbacks. He is a professional hitter, someone who would help them a lot against right-handed pitching. But who knows? Maybe they're at this point ready to decide, you know what, this young group of hitters we've assembled, not all of them have progressed the way we wanted to, and maybe they break it up.
Joe Maddon, is he at all playing for a job, or is he safe?
He is safe, in my opinion, during the season. Once the season is over and his contract expires, if they were a disappointment, I would expect that they would make a change. In fact, I was a little bit surprised they did not make a change at the end of last season because I was hearing things even then about the possibility that Theo Epstein might think they need a new direction. They've been talking about all these different things they want to do, create greater urgency, a different tone in the clubhouse. Well, these are code words for we want the manager to do some things differently. Joe Maddon has, and listen, they've been a great second half team under him, but yes, his job is at stake.
You know, Kenny, I've spoken to a lot of players, KB, and they're happy with him. He's doing more coaching. He seems energized. With my time around him, he still seems like he's at the top of his game. Sometimes the answer is not the manager.
Agreed. And it's interesting, too, guys. Perhaps they overrated what they had a little bit. Schwarber is not the player they thought. Russell, not the player they thought. Almora, okay. Ian Happ's in the minor leagues. So while Chris Bryant and Baez and Contreras have become really good players, that whole group hasn't developed as one. So, yeah, maybe they need to do something different.
You know, there's just one last thing on the Cubs, then I want to move on to something else. But, Frank, I thought Frank brought up a great name, Kenny. Just kind of, we were just kind of spitballing and having lunch before the show. Whit Merrifield, that just feels like a good fit for the Cubs. Guy that's a great second baseman, can play anywhere, can play the outfield, move around. That, I don't know, Frank brought up, I kind of like that idea for
them. It's a great name, and Cubs fans have been salivating over that name. I don't expect it's going to happen.
Because Frank, I tried.
He's under a long-term, club-friendly deal. The Royals love him. They think he can be part of their future, even though he's a little bit older. And to get him, it's going to take major league pieces. Now, maybe the Cubs would part with some, but it's just a lot to ask from the Royals because I just don't think they want to trade
him.
Big hurt, right? Rosenthal.
He's getting scoops news today.
I just watched that team yesterday, and you can watch this team. They're not motivated right now.
Powers of observation. He knows
exactly
what he's
saying. All right, Kenny, we got more with you next hour of the show, so thanks. We'll have more on the Yanks, more on the Phils with Kenny.